There's a voice that cries out in the silence, searching for a heart that will love him.
Hi, I'm Latasha Haskins, your 2010 Miss Plus America, and I am in Nashville, Tennessee for the 26th annual Gospel Music Stellar Awards. I am so excited to be here with two very, very special people, the leaders, the mom and dad of the group Forever Jones. My godparents, the beautiful Kim Jones, and the handsome and ever-looking my godfather, and my father's BFF, Dwayne Jones.
Absolutely.
So I'm so glad that you guys are here. It took a few moments after the show. They've been going all day long. I don't know, probably the last 12 hours, however long, for the last like week, but they took some time to have a little intimate interview with me, their goddaughter, and also, you know, new Stellar Award recipients and Grammy nominees.
Yes.
So we're gonna take a little time to chat with them.
Yeah, and we're so very proud of you, Tasha, really, honestly. You know, just, you know, Miss Plus Size America 2010, we're just so exciting. And just, I think that you're a great representative.
Thank you.
You know, that organization, you know, they're blessed to have you. Mm-hmm.
Well, thank you. I'm excited. I'm hoping that I'm making a difference.
Oh, you are.
You know, and even trying to transcend just being in plus size venues, you know, going to other events, being around different kinds of people, and hopefully inspire them to try for the goals. Just really quickly, before you guys get to bed, tell us kind of just how did you go from small town in Yakima, Washington, to, you know, Louisiana, and now, you know, Stellar Award recipients and prayerfully Grammy Award recipients. I mean, how does that happen?
Well, it's definitely a God thing.
Yeah.
We're not confused about how we got here. We got here on just because of the favor of God that was on us. Doing what we do naturally, just meeting with God and God giving us the songs that we sing and that are on the CD. And the single, Dominique has the same testimony. She says that one day her dad says, come away with me, come on, let's go pray. So she took her guitar and he was trying to teach her how.
I told her, I said, come on, you know, let's go pray. I said, and bring your guitar with me. And so that's how that story went. She came in and I think we were just praying. We were just praying and, you know, about letting go of idols and stuff like that. And the Lord dropped that song on her.
There are songs that our kids write that, that's just me. I just feel like that song, the world has to hear.
Oh, wow.
Because if it does what it does to me, I could not imagine what it would do, you know, when other people hear it. So that song, I would ask her, have you seen that song? And she just didn't want to sing it. No, Mom. So I'd have to beg her to sing the song.
Wow.
But that.
But she's happy she sang it now.
Well, yeah, just, you know, I'm sure she's happy knowing that God used her. He's using her
absolutely
to reach so many people.
So now I will tell you, I will give you a sneak preview that that our next single, which is, it's not officially out, but they're just playing it already, is Time to Believe.
Oh, wow.
And that's the song that Janelle
I'm so excited.
It's almost charted. It's not officially out yet, so we're excited about that.
What are your words to, I guess, hopeful gospel artists or hopeful musicians out there that feel like they have a, you know, not just a testimony to share, but just a ministry through music that they want the world to see, and maybe they're having a tough time getting into the industry. I mean, you guys tarried for years. For years, and so many people were like, you need to do this, and you need to do that, and you guys just totally waited on God, and thank God you waited on God. I mean, because it probably wouldn't have happened this way if you guys would have tried to do it in your own might. But what do you say to those aspiring artists, and how did you get there, and we want to be like you? And
well, you know, I would, you know, Tasha, I would just encourage them to just start where they're at and start in their Jerusalem.